Good morning, Tiger Cubs and friends. I'm so excited that you all are sharing this with family and friends. It's so much fun, so why not? Today, we're going to read a story about our friend Gerald, the giraffe. Because giraffes can't dance. It's a good book, and it's silly and fun. So let's get started. Gerald was a tall giraffe whose neck was long and slim, but his knees were awfully crooked and his legs were rather thin. He was very good at standing still and munching shoots of trees, and when he tried to run around, he buckled at his knees. Oh no, he crashed so hard. Now every year in Africa, they hold the jungle dance where every single animal turns up to skip and prance. And this year, when the day arrived, poor Gerald was sad because when it came to dancing, he was very, really bad. The warthogs started waltzing, the rhinos rock and rolled, the lions danced a tango that was elegant and bold. So many dancing friends. The chimps all did a cha-cha, and with a very Latin feel, the eight baboons then teamed up for a splendid Scottish reel. Gerald swallowed bravely, and he walked toward the floor, but the lions saw him coming, and they soon began to roar. Hey, look, the clumsy Gerald, the animals all snared. Giraffes can't dance, you silly fool. Oh, Gerald, you're so weird. Those are not very nice words to say to people. Gerald simply froze up. He was rooted in his spot. They're right, he thought. I'm useless. Oh, I feel like such a clot. So he crept off from the dance floor, and he started walking home. He never felt so sad before, so sad and so alone. They were so mean to him. I'd be sad too. Then he found a little clearing and he looked up at the sky. The moon can be so beautiful, he whispered with a sigh. Excuse me, coughed a cricket who'd seen Gerald earlier on, but sometimes when you're different, you just need a different song. Listen to the swaying grass and listen to the trees. To me, the sweetest music is the branches in the breeze. So imagine the lovely moon is playing just for you. Everything makes music if you really want it to. Ooh, what's he gonna do? With that, the cricket smiled and picked up his violin. Then Gerald felt his body do the most amazing thing. His hoofs started shuffling, making circles on the ground. His neck was gently swaying and his tail was swishing round. What's he doing? He threw his legs out sideways and he swung them everywhere. Then he did a backward somersault and leapt up in the air. I can't do that. Gerald felt so wonderful. His mouth was open wide. I am dancing. Yes, I'm dancing. I am dancing, Gerald cried. Look how happy he is. Then one by one, each animal who'd been there at the dance arrived while Gerald boogied on and watched him quite entranced. They shouted, it's a miracle. We must be in a dream. Gerald's the best dancer we ever seen. Wow, look at him kick and spin and Pages are sticking together. How did you learn to dance like that? Please, Gerald, tell us how. But Gerald simply twirled around and finished with a bow. He's so proud. Then he raised his head and looked up at the moon and stared at the stars above. We all can dance, he said, when you find music that we love. Oh, friends, what type of music do you love? Miss Bree likes dancing music. So I have something to show you. I'll be right back. Who's gonna get up and dance? Show me your moves. Everybody up and dance. Look, Gerald's gonna dance. Who can be your John Travolta? I hope you all have a great day today. Don't forget, tomorrow's beach day, so we're gonna have fun. I hope to see some videos of you all dancing today. Have a good night.